Genesis chapter 11 verse 10 explains the genealogy of Shem. Shem was a black man in Africa. If you repeat this fact, they can't laugh at you. If you repeat this fact, they can't laugh at you. If you repeat this fact, Genesis chapter 11 verse 10 explains the genealogy of Shem. Shem was a black man in Africa. If you repeat this fact, they can't laugh at you. Genesis 14 verse 13.
I gotta ask you one more thing because we need to know, man. What is our status when it comes to voting, man? What is our status when it comes to the police as black men? What is our status as black women and black men in this country right now? We want to hear from Blastmaster KRS-One, man. What is our status, man? What do we do? How do we approach this, man, as being black men with the police and voting? And because we under so much pressure, man.
Yep.
We pressure from so many different directions to do this and do that. They got vaccines coming. All this stuff is flying towards us, man.
Yep.
Give us something that can anchor us, man. You know, as for young black men out here, man, and black women, and all ethnicities right now that's going through something, man. What do you think about today's times, man?
Yo, I tell you, man, what a timely question. And of course, you know, we don't even have time to talk. Dang. Really? This is like a 2 hour. This is a 3 hour just on this question.
I can dig
right
it.
Here.
Yeah.
I'll say this, and I appreciate the question too, because for those listening, you know, the hardest thing to realize, black people first. I'm talking to black people first right now. The hardest thing for us to realize as a people is that we are the gods of this earth.
Mm-hmm.
This is what we pray to God. We become Muslim, Buddha, Christian, Jewish, everything except ourselves.
Mm.
And all of these religions, all of them were...
Say that again, except ourselves.
Except us. Us. The reason we are in the United States right now is because they stole our religion, our sense of government, everything. And guess what? Not only did they steal it, the true kings gave it away and said, you know what? We as black men and women, really, to be honest with you, it was the woman that set this up. It was the black queen is called the Kandake and in Africa. And the Kandake, the black king, is called the Negus Nagas, king of kings, lord of lords.
Negus Nagas, not Negus. I know y'all think he said Nagas.
No, wait a minute. Yo, you're going to get me stretched out because that's where this word, because the word nigger, N-I-G-E-R, not Niger or Niger, none of that makes any sense. That has no etymological significance.
So is that a correct spelling of that word, double G?
Yes, the correct spelling of the word nigger is N-I-G-E-R, not two G's, one
G-E-R.
Yes, N-I-G-E-R is the original spelling of the word nigger.
They put two G's on it.
They put two G's on it to degrade the one G.
Oh, man.
Okay, they put two G's on it to degrade the one. What they're calling us is a degradation, but the word itself is not a degradation. In fact, the original niggas are teachers and prophets. The original niggas, N-I-G-E-R. Matter of fact, because I want to...
Wow, come on with it, man. Come on with it.
But I'll say this to you for the people listening. Go to Acts 13 in the Bible. Go and grab your Bible. Go to Acts 13 in the Bible. In Acts 13, you'll see the only time the word nigger is mentioned, N-I-G-E-R, it's mentioned in a story of how the first church was built. All theologians know this. The very first church ever built, the Christian church ever built, was in Antioch, in the region of Antioch, Syria, out there. This was all black folk out there, the original Syria, all black folk.
The first church. Libya. The first church.
The first, not the second, not the third. Not
first
the
ever.
The first church, the first Christian church is in Antioch. And the ones who established it were niggers. N-I-G-E-R-S. Niggers. Go to your...
And it wasn't called Eastside Baptist either, was it?
It wasn't none of that. It was called nigger. Okay? And so you go there and you look. Now, there's a bunch more to deal with that because the etymology of the word nigger is really Ethiopian. What they're saying, when you look at the word nigger, they'll say commonly called the Ethiopian, known as the Ethiopian. When you say nigger, you really referring to the Ethiopian, the ancient Ethiopians who were astronomers, architects, agriculturalists. It's this white dude, this racist, that's degrading our names. And because we believe in this dude so much, we say, oh man, we shouldn't use the word nigger. We shouldn't use the word nigger. Nah, you should always use the word nigger because that is the word that defeated them. That's what, imagine a colonist, which is what they are, imperialists and colonists. They coming in your land to steal your stuff. That's their only purpose, okay? So they go there and they say, who's the king? They say, the nigger, right here. And some call us the nigger, the nega, the naga, and the negus. All of these are the same words.
Naga.
They say, yo, that's the nigger, the king, right there. You go try to diss the king by saying, oh, nigger. Like, you're going to degrade. It's sort of like saying...
That's deep. I get it.
It's sort of like saying Michael Jordan. And then you say Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan's one of the greatest athletes on the planet, okay?
So it's all about... So that word is so powerfully disrespectful in this country because
white folks are degrading it.
It's the emotion behind it and the real true feeling about the word.
Because white folk are saying nigga while they hating us, we don't want to use the word. But what we got to understand is that the very word nigger, N-I-G-E-R, that word means king. That was our word. So imagine if China was to invade America, the first thing they would say is president is a derogatory term. Anybody calling themselves a
president is derogatory.
You let 3-4 generations go by of you being taught in school president is a racial epithet. President is not what you want to say. Don't say president. You let some generations go by. After a while, you don't even want to say president anymore, even though Barack Obama is our first African American president. So it's this white colonial racist, actually institutional racism that's making us hate ourselves. And this is what self-hate is. You would think, somebody say, if you say the word nigger, you're hating yourself, you're degrading yourself. Nah, if you're not saying the word nigger, you're degrading yourself. Because the reason the word nigger is offensive is only because the white racist made it that way. We never said the word nigger was offensive for 100,000 years.
Yeah, most of us don't even know where the word, most of us think they made the word up.
No, they didn't. That's an African word.
Wow.
Nigger. That's an African word. And it's associated with the river, actually, with rivers and river people. The beginnings of civilization, basically.
Genesis chapter 11, verse 10. Explains the genealogy of Shem. Shem was a black man in Africa. If you repeat this fact, they can't laugh at you. Genesis 14, verse 13. Abraham steps on the scene, being a descendant of Shem, which is a fact, means Abraham too was black. Abraham born in the city of a black man called Nimrod, grandson of Ham. Ham had 4 sons. One was named Canaan. Here, let me do some explaining. Abraham was the father of Isaac. Isaac was the father of Jacob. Jacob had 12 sons, for real, and these were the children of Israel. According to Genesis chapter 10, Egyptians descended from Ham. 600 years later, my brother read up. Moses was born in Egypt. In this era, black Egyptians weren't right. They enslaved black Israelites. Moses had to be
envy of the black race, because he spent 40 years in Pharaoh's place. He passed as the Pharaoh's grandson, so he had to look just like him. Yes, my brothers and sisters, take this here song. Yo, correct the wrong. The information we get today is just whack. But ask yourself, why is that? But ask yourself, why is that? But ask yourself, why is that? But ask